Hi everybody, and welcome to this playlist where we will perform a complete project architecture, which is going to be a great exercise to practice your knowledge in AutoCAD. We will make this step by step, explaining the commands that I'm using in each situation. However, some parts that are just repeating a specific method, I will fast forward it in order to not make this video very long. This exercise is the floor plan of the ground floor. On the description of the video, you can find the link to download the PDF file, so you can easily follow the measurements. Let's start! Okay, this is the main window that appears whenever we start AutoCAD. To start a new drawing, I'm going to click here to choose a template from this list. And for curiosity, ACAD.DWT is for imperial units, like inches or feet, and ACAD.ISO is for metrical. However, it's possible to edit these settings later, there is no problem for that. Once we open our new file, we can start editing the units. We type units and press Enter to open the drawing units window. In this drawing, we will use millimeters as the units on this project. So, we choose decimal here for the type, and then the precision can be just zero. That's because we are not going to use lines or with dimensions under 1 millimeter. At the angle, we can keep the settings defined by default. And on insertion scale, we set the units that we are using in this file. They are millimeters. And by the way, the units in this tab are just needed to export content to another file. But anyway, I think it's always better to define the correct units here. Then close the window. Now, in this floor plan, we are going to start drawing the walls, so it's time to create new layers on this project. I'm going to click on the layer properties, is this icon here. Then here, I click with the right button, go to new layer, and create a new layer with the name walls, for example. The important is that you give an easy name to recognize it. And also be aware that here the layers are displayed by alphabetical order. Then for the color, I keep it white. Ah, but an important note, the layer 0, we don't want to draw objects there, as this is a kind of no layer, and we will just use it to create blocks. But don't worry, that's something you will learn later on this tutorial. Then, on the status bar, we are not going to use the grid and snap modes for now, so we just turn them off. I turn on the ortho mode to draw horizontal and vertical lines, and with that activated, it's going to be much faster to draw. You will see, as in this project, almost everything is horizontal and vertical. Along with that, we need the object snap turned on. And that's crucial if we want to connect and intersect objects in precise points. Clicking on the arrow, I can switch on or off the modes that we need during this project. So, let's start drawing. But first, I'm going to specify the current layer to walls. I'm going to activate now the command polyline and the first line, I will draw it with a length of 4900 mm. Then it follows one vertically down with 400. Then it's 2200. After 700 mm. Then 3700. And I just need to follow the lengths on the PDF file until I reach the beginning. And remember that the line lengths here have to be on millimeters. Then the last line, I will draw it vertically. And if I can connect vertically this line with the origin, it means that almost sure I have typed all the lengths correctly. For the interior outline of these external walls, I am going to use the command offset. Set for the offset distance 350. Click on the polyline and make an offset to the internal side. And that was a simple way to draw all the external walls. What's next? The internal walls. But before continuing, let's save this drawing with a specific name. For drawing the internal walls, I will be using a lot the command polyline and offset. But of course, there are hundreds of ways to make this process. I decided to start from the garage. With the command polyline, I go to this endpoint, move to the right, type 2700 and draw this vertical line towards the opposite external wall. Then I click now when the object snap point perpendicular shows up. Then let's make the internal outline of the laundry room using the dimensions from the PDF file. Press enter to use the polyline again. Now I type 2050 mm to the right. Then this line has a length of 3400. The next, I can hove that endpoint. It's possible to do this even in the orthomode. Then I go down and click on this intersection. Finally, I'm going to connect to the endpoint. After this, I go to the lobby. And I will make this side. From here, I draw 1700 up, then 1400 to the left. And for this line, I need to add the width of the wall to 1650, the distance marked in the PDF. And the total is 1800. That's what I need to type. Let's now use the offset to the following. The offset distance is the wall width 150 mm. Click on the line at the right of the garage and click again for putting a new line on this side. Next, without pressing any key, I offset the polyline at the laundry. And then the other one here. Great, so I can now press enter. Next, I'm going to select these two polylines and by clicking on this grip, I can move this endpoint to the intersection. On the one next to it, when I click, you can see this box that appears. And why? Because there are two objects overlapped and the selection cycling is switched on. The first polyline is the one that is now selected, so I click and then I do the same action as before. Now, as this process takes a few minutes and also because I think you will be able to complete the walls by yourself, I'm going to fast forward it and focus only in specific details. For example, here I have overlapped lines. But don't worry because we will delete all the duplicate objects at the end. So if you think you will save time putting some objects above others, it's okay for the moment. Then in the living room, I put temporarily a thick wall dividing it from the next part of the house. Now I want to offset these lines, but as I drew them with the command line, I need to merge them to a single polyline. That's simple. We can do this easily with the command join. Then I'm going to offset the last object 150 mm to the right. Then draw the remaining walls, all the dimension lines, are available on the PDF file. Once I finish, I'm going to use the command trim. I click on the command, select all the objects, press enter, and then I erase the segments that I don't need. A good way to not forget to delete any lines is to start, for example, on the left side and go progressively to the right part. After trimming all that I need, there can be still some duplicate objects here. On the Modify panel, I click on this arrow and find the icon Delete Duplicate Objects. I select everything, and on this window I can keep the default options because all the objects have the same layer properties. Press Enter and all the duplicate lines were erased. Okay, before stepping forward to the next chapter, we have some dashed lines to insert here. First, I use the command line to draw them in their own place. I select them, and after I go to the layer properties and click on the option to change the line type for the layer walls. Currently, there is just one line type available for this layer. Click on Load to access more. In all these options, I'm going to select this one. Then, I close the window. With the line selected, right-click, I go to the Properties, and I can now change the line type to the new one. Nice! As you see now, the lines have a dashed appearance. The only problem is that it's a bit hard to see, as it has a small scale. So what I need to do is to change the scale to a bigger value. Here. For example, if I change to 5, I can see it better. But let's put even a bit more. 8. Now it's okay. Finally, we finished drawing the walls, and to make sure we are not going to modify these objects accidentally, I'm going to lock the layer for now. It's on this icon. So, as you see, the colors now are darker. I'm not able to modify anything in that layer, although I can always select the objects or use its object snap points. That can be useful to draw objects in another layers. Okay, back on the layer properties, let's create three new layers. For the first, I give the name of staircase. The second, doors. And the last one, windows. Oh, as they are locked, I have to select them and click here. For now, I'm going to set light colors for each of them, as they are easy to distinguish on my workspace. And don't worry, because for printing purposes, I will choose darker colors. The next element that I'm going to draw is the staircase. It's not hard, but it has a couple of details. First, don't forget to change the current layer here to staircase, that's very important. Then, turn on the command line. As the thread width is 25 cm, go to this endpoint, move up, and type 250. Draw a horizontal line up to the opposite wall. Next, with the command offset, I type O and press enter, I can draw the other threads very quickly. Specify 250 for the offset distance. Click on the line. Then I can see on the prompt sentence, specify point on side to offset or these three options. I'm going to choose multiple, type M and press enter, to place several objects with a 250 mm distance between each other. It's very simple, I just click 4 times and press enter. Now I'm going to draw the railing, this is very easy. The first line is located at 50 mm from the wall. I draw it vertically till the top. And the second line, also 50 mm, but this time to the left of the first line. Then the last rises. It's a bit more complicated, but I will show you one of the several ways to do it. I'm going to start with the vertical line, which is where the staircase starts. It's located at 1250 mm from the wall, and the length of the line is a bit shorter, just 870 mm. And that is the run width of the first riser. Then I'm going to draw an arc using the start, center, and end points. I click here for the start point. The center, I'm going to place it at 300 mm down. And the end point, I click here. Next, I'm going to offset the arc with a distance of 50 mm to the other railing outline. To draw the remaining threads, I'm going to use the path array. It's located here. I select the object to array and then I click on the path. And what happened? More than 400 lines were generated because the spacement between objects by default was set to 1 mm. Don't worry, because if I click on this icon, I can unlock the number of items, and then I can set 5, which is the number that I want. Finally, to distribute these 5 lines equally along all the path, I have to change the option measure here and switch to divide. Now it looks better, but before saving this array, uncheck associative to not convert this to an array object. Now, I just need to extend those lines to the walls. I type EX and press enter. Select the boundary edges. And then click on the lines to extend. Ah, but I'm going to reactivate the command again to extend the lines also to this arc. Okay, finally, you can draw this end side of the railing. As it doesn't have specific dimensions, just do it how you wish. It's not very important. So, to finish the stair, I'm going to trim the line segments that are not necessary. For example, those ones inside the circle. Then press escape and delete those two lines. And trim these parts of the railing. Get rid of this duplicate line. Press delete because there was another under it. And to be more organized, I select the objects and group them. So that's the end of the first part of this tutorial. And don't forget to continue to part 2 by clicking on the video that is showing here. There we will complete all the remaining parts of this floor plan. So don't miss it.